Good morning, everyone. How's everyone doing today? I'm just streaming live from the garden today. It's an absolutely gorgeous day here in Southern California. I think the weather is around 70 or 75 degrees. Really feels like spring. It's actually kind of hot out here today. And I was going to actually shoot a video, but I decided why not try and live stream? Because, shooting a video takes a lot more time. So thought, well, I might as well come out here and just share with you guys what I'm doing. Hi, everyone. Hi, Pam. How are you? It's great to see you on here this morning. And let's see, Cridgen the best. How are you? Tara, hi, how are you? It's so nice to see you. Tyler, good morning. Rosie's cheeks. Very, very nice to see you all here today. Thank you so much for joining me. It's an absolutely gorgeous morning out here in my garden. And I wanted to bring you along and just share with you what I have going on today. It is a beautiful day, as you can see. Things are starting to get green. Things are starting to look really good. And I really need to spend a lot more time out here and get my garden in good shape here. With all the rain, I've got a lot of weeds coming up. So I'm out here today doing some maintenance, going to take a look at the compost pile. And I'm also discovering some aphids here on a couple of my plants that I wanted to take care of. Hello, Rosaline from Florida, from Fontana. Wow, we have people all over the place joining us this morning. I didn't know how things would go with the morning live stream, but thought, what the heck, let's give it a go. So let me just show you guys what I'm going to be working on today. I've got my little smart pots garden here, and they need a little bit of attention. So you can see they're looking a little bit wilted. I haven't had to water for quite a while because we've had so much rain. But this is the plant here that I'm really concerned about. Now, I actually let this one go just a little bit because I wanted to show you guys what was going on. I didn't have time to shoot a video. So, yeah, the sunshine here is gorgeous. Hopefully, you guys are getting some sunshine as well. And hopefully, the cold weather will end wherever you are very soon. Because if you realize it, we only have about 10 or 12, I just posted on Instagram, I think about 12 more days until spring, the official start of spring. So this is super exciting. Just launched our $10 Garden Series Season 2 video on Saturday. Hopefully you guys were able to catch that. But super exciting. People are getting their seeds started or getting outdoors. And it's just a very exciting time of the year to be out in the garden and getting things going with your warm weather vegetables. So welcome. And let me show you what I have going on here. This is a Brussels sprouts plant. Now it's not looking too good right now, and like I said, I did let it go a little bit long, so I wanted to show you guys what was going on. But I've got some aphids here. Let's see, it might be a little bit difficult to see. I don't know if you guys can see that if it's in the sun. Let me move out of the way a little bit. Can you guys see those aphids in there? Okay, that is definitely not good. We do not want aphids on this plant. You can see how the leaves are curling. That's a sign of aphids. So we're gonna get this plant taken care of today. I think there's a whole bunch of them on here. Oh, this is not looking good at all. I should have gotten out here a couple days sooner. So look down in here. Okay, some aphids. Let me see if I can get some of these leaves out of the way so you guys can see. Okay, this plant has a pretty bad infestation. So what I'm gonna do is a couple things. First of all, I'm going to try and get my camera set up here so you guys can see it. So bear with me just a second here. So yeah, Chris, you are super lucky you don't get aphids. I don't know where you live, but yeah, I don't usually have too many, but right now I think because of all the moisture and everything, they like these Brussels sprouts and the broccoli. Okay, there, I think I got my camera situated so you guys can see that. Hi, Chastity, how are you? Nice to have you on here. And I'm not sure if camera guy was able to log in from work and take a look at the chat, but hopefully he's there moderating. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is, first off, I'm just gonna start with my hose here. So I always like to just first start with a nice little spray of water from my hose. And I like to go in and just rinse off the leaves. Now, normally I wouldn't spray the leaves with a hose. I usually try and water at the base of the plant. But, in this case, I want to try and get all the aphids off that I can. So I'm just going to go in here and wet this plant down. And I try and rub the aphids off as I'm doing this. So I'll go through, especially this plant because it's pretty heavily infested, and I'll just rub the aphids off with my hands. And you have to uncurl all the leaves and really get down in there. Here's a bunch of yellowing leaves, so I'm going to pull those out. And you really want to get down in there and really get all the aphids rubbed off that you can. It's a little bit time consuming, so that's why it's always better, like I say, to start with, you know, prevention is always the best cure. But if you don't get out here and prevent it in time, this is a great way to do it too. Okay, so I think you guys got that idea. I won't go through into the whole plant right now. I'll do it after the live stream is over. But basically, you want to do that for the whole plant, making sure you get on top and underneath of the leaves. And then I've got my little handy-dandy hand pump sprayer. I can't really hear you. Okay, sorry about that. I think that my camera maybe is a little bit too far away. So I'll try and just hold my phone and get a little bit closer so you guys can hopefully see this. But I've got my little handy-dandy hand pump sprayer. I love this. It's so handy. I use it in the house too, but I brought it out here this morning. And this is so cool. So it's really nice to do this for like a small area. You probably wouldn't want to do it if you had a big large garden. You'd want to get like a larger type of sprayer. But what I basically have in here, I've got some neem oil. Neem oil is great for pest control. I don't always like to use neem oil. A lot of times I'll use it as a last resort when I'm outdoors. I really like to try the water approach first, but this plant is so heavily infested. I wanted to get some neem oil on it. I also put some worm tea in it because if you guys watch the worm tea video, we learned that worm tea is especially good for keeping your plants healthy. And then when it's healthy, it's going to fend off the pests. So I'm going to use it as a foliar spray as well. And I also put a little bit of some essential oil in here that's like a cinnamon. I put a peppermint oil in. And it's always good to go that natural route and get some good essential oils in here. I actually used that in my garden a little bit last summer. Seemed to work pretty well, so I'm going to give it a go again. So we're just going to spray this baby down as good as we can. And I'm going to get the undersides of the leaves. I'm going to get the tops of the leaves. I'm going to get down in here too. And make sure I just coat this baby down with my little organic bug spray solution. And normally I would do this, I would recommend doing this in the early morning or in the late afternoon when it's a little bit shady. Today I'm actually in bright sunlight, but I may just go ahead and move this container into the shade when I'm done just to give it a little bit of a break. I'll give it a good watering also with worm tea. So basically you guys get the idea, get in here and spray this baby down, just really douse it really good with neem oil, my little solution here. And the important thing to know though about organic bug control, pest control, is that it's not a one and done solution. You really have to do it regularly. You know, the chemical pesticides you can spray once, it kills the bugs and that's done. But the neem oil and the other things I put in there really work over the long term. So what they're gonna do is disrupt the life cycle of the aphids and the other pests that are on your plants and help them not to reproduce. That's why it's important to go ahead and wash off all the aphids that you can first. So hopefully they don't come back, and the ones that do come back, you know, hopefully they'll get that neem oil in them and then they won't reproduce. That will really help because the aphids, believe me, they reproduce so quickly that, you know, you just want to get rid of them as soon as possible. So if there's any other suggestions that you have for getting rid of aphids, you know, pop it in the chat below, or if you've tried neem oil with success, would love to hear more about it too. I know several of you have mentioned that you're trying the neem cake, which I know that Gary over the Rusted Garden has now on his website and have been having some good success with that. So let me know if you've tried that. I haven't tried that yet, but I definitely would like to get myself some. And with that, you can just kind of sprinkle it down in the soil, and then as those fungus gnats, which a lot of us have problems with in indoor growing, lay their eggs, or any other pests lay their eggs in the soil, they're gonna get in there and get that neem cake and hopefully will not reproduce. So Tara is asking, do I use DE? You know what, I have used DE a couple of times, and for those of you that don't know, that's diatomaceous earth. I actually have some and I'd forgotten that I have it. So there are a couple comments on the video I posted the other day on the indoor cucumber and tomato that I should use that. So I'm actually gonna get that out again and give that a try, especially with my indoor plants. The outdoor plants, I've tried it before, and it seems like it just kind of sinks down into the soil after I water, but I really haven't tried it long enough to see if it actually works for me. So if you've had great success with that, you can pop that in the chat as well, and I would love to hear more about that also. So let's see, backyard gardener is ready to garden. Still have a way to go here in Michigan. I think it's still pretty cold there in Michigan, right? Do you have like a couple months still before you can get things planted outside? Maybe in May or June? I'm not sure how that works out there, but hopefully you're getting some seed started. So that's really great if you can get seed started now. And that way you have some transplants to put into your garden as soon as your last frost date is passed. So if you haven't checked out my seed starting video, make sure you go and check that out. It's a lot of fun to have seeds started and have all your warm weather seeds germinating. And that way you have some transplants to put into the ground. And I really love starting with transplants because that way you can get going sooner. Save yourself a lot of money. You don't have to buy all the transplants at the garden center, but also you can grow some really fun varieties. And you really just can't find those fun varieties at the garden center. There's just the possibilities are endless. And I'm starting my garden with a $10 garden seed kit from MI Gardener. So if you need seeds, you might want to check that out. I know he was out of stock the day that we posted the video. And I just checked on his website. It looks like he's still out of stock. But I know he will hopefully be restocking that very soon. And make sure you get your 10% discount, migardener.com/CallieKim29, whenever you purchase seeds through his website. And also check out on my website, I have a couple new tabs that I wanted to let you guys know about. I have my partners tab, the companies that I'm partnering with, like MI Gardener and Vermistera for the worm castings and the worm tea. You can check out their products over there, and the promo codes and the discount codes that you'll get your 10% discount are all over there too. They're all linked up. And I also have some recommended products that I have over on Amazon. So I have my Amazon store. So check that out also. And whenever you purchase products through those links, if you're going to be getting gardening products also, you could help me out by going over to my website and purchasing your garden products through those links there. And then that really helps me out. So I really appreciate that. It just helps me be able to keep the garden content coming, making the videos, and providing all the tips and tricks and everything that I love to do for you guys. So, oh good, I'm glad that you're able to catch me. You're not at work today. That's great. You get the day off in the middle of the week. Okay, Tara, thank you so much for that information. MI Gardener posted he'll be back in stock on Friday. So that's good to know. So if you haven't been able to get his seeds, head on over there on Friday and make sure that you check out his website. He's got a great selection of seeds for your spring garden. So thank you so much, Luke, for joining us today. I'm glad that you love my channel and a video for everything. Well, that's kind of my goal. I'm trying to get a video for everything out there. I'm sure there's a few things that either I don't grow or I haven't grown that there aren't videos out there, but we really do try and keep it quick, simple, inexpensive, get going with your spring garden. So hello, Rod, good to see you here from Baja. And let me just show you a couple other things that I have going on here. There's so much that I want to do, just not enough time. Here is an absolutely gorgeous broccoli plant, and I've let this one flower and go to seed. Thought it would be fun to see the beautiful yellow flowers and to bring in some bees. So I'm just going to let this one go. I'll probably trim off or cut off some of these little side shoots that you see growing out here. So that'll be a lot of fun. But that's really pretty, and I actually haven't even looked at these plants here to see if I even have any cauliflower or broccoli, more broccoli heads going on, but it's getting warm, so I'm hoping that they don't all just bolt and go to seed. Oh, here's some absolutely gorgeous. Look at this. See, I haven't been out here for a few days, so you miss a lot when you miss a few days in the garden. I've got some really nice peas here, and gosh, these are absolutely beautiful. Absolutely, oh wow, these look great. Let me just try one of these. Mmm, these are sugar snap peas. These are, oh my gosh, these are so good. If you guys haven't planted sugar snap peas, you definitely need to do that. They're not only a great garden snack, you can just eat them right off the vine. Mmm, oh wow. These are so, so sweet. But they grow super, super fast. Wow, I'll turn this around so you guys can see. They grow super, super fast. Crop. They sprout in a couple days, they'll grow to maturity in about 6 weeks. So it's really a good crop to start with early in the spring. You can even plant them like 4 weeks before your last frost date. You can get them going inside the house, you can plant them directly in the garden. Absolutely delicious. And if you haven't gotten my free growing guide, by the way, head over to my website and definitely pick that up, because there's all about growing peas in there, all about growing lettuce, and all about growing beans. Some quick crops to get you started, to get you off to the right foot with your spring garden. Also a lot of full color photos of my garden, so definitely go over and check that out as well. So let me head over into the shade so I can see the chat. Can't see it in the full sun, but they never make them in the house. I know, Tara, that's about the way I am too. They're on the vine, and before you know it, they're in my stomach, and they don't make it in the house. So nobody else really ever gets to have them. I know, a pick and eat breakfast in the garden is the best. And the peas are super sweet. Have to go in and get me a nice cup of green tea to bring out here and have with my peas. So, or a glass of kombucha, that would be great too. So let's see, Chastity is asking about fungus gnats in my outside pots, but my plants are still growing strong. Can they ruin the veggies? Well, fungus gnats definitely can be detrimental. They can get down in the roots and kind of gnaw away at the veggies, but they're really more detrimental to the young seedlings. So if your plants are, you know, going strong and a little bit more mature, they're kind of pesky and kind of annoying, but they probably will, your plants probably will be okay. But it definitely doesn't hurt to spray them with some neem oil. Sprinkle some cinnamon over the surface of your plants or some diatomaceous earth, like Tara had mentioned earlier, and get rid of them if you can. But you know, sometimes they're just really, really difficult to get rid of. I did have a viewer comment about using essential oils on the fungus gnats too, which is definitely something I'm going to be trying more. I really love essential oils, and it's a great natural way to get rid of the pests. So let's see. Can you do a $10 garden video for a worm tower? Do you have tips for winter plants? Okay. I do actually have a video on making a worm bin. I probably won't be making a new one this year because it is just, for me, it's a little bit time consuming, and I don't get the castings that I really need for my garden out of it. So since I've been using the Vermistero worm castings this way, it's just an easier way for me, a lot quicker for me. But definitely go over and check out that worm bin video, because I know a lot of people really do enjoy doing the worm bin. It is a lot of fun, and it's just something that's fun to experiment with. So go over and check out that video too. Okay, so Pam is using DE as well. Great. It's always good to hear some other tips from people that are doing something that works. So thank you so much for sharing that, Pam. So let's see if I have any other questions. Hi, The Passionate Gardener. Hi, great to have you on here. And Bipolar Kush is asking about spinosad. I have actually never used spinosad before. So if you have some good success stories with that, I would definitely love to hear about that. Either pop that in the comments once this video replays, or pop it in the chat here. So it'd be always good to hear. So Kim, thank you so much for joining me. Have a good rest of your day back at work. I'm glad that you could check in and join us for a little bit here during your work day. Thank you so much. So guys, I think that's gonna be about it for me here in the garden. I got a lot to do today. Also gotta check out my compost pile up at the top of my hill. I gotta turn it and water it down and make sure that my compost is coming along. So I'm really glad that you guys joined me. Please pop comments down below in the replay of this video. Let me know what you're planting for your spring garden. I would love to hear more about it and love to hear how your seedlings are doing. And even if you can check out pictures over on Instagram and Facebook and post a picture over on my Facebook page too, that would be great. So thank you so much for joining me today. Really look forward to growing along with everyone in our spring gardens. And make sure you check out my blog. I did just post a new blog post over there yesterday. So check out things over there, comment over there too, let me know that you visited, and really look forward to spring coming in just 12 days. All right, guys, great to have you here in the garden with me today. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.